Now, from the Ford Sports Desk, KOMU 8 Sports.
We have been tracking the entirety of the 2021 Norm Stewart Classic, 48 straight hours of boys and girls high school basketball played at Mizzou Arena, and plenty of stars taking the court, including the younger brother of a former Missouri Tiger. A star-studded affair between Chaminade and Tolton, all eyes on Javon Porter, younger brother of Michael Porter Jr., and Javon would get going early. Here's the alley-oop from Aaron Rowe to Porter for the slam dunk, and he would show it off on the defensive end next. He gets the block on Chaminade, Trailblazers running in transition. Here's Aaron Rowe, the slam dunk. This kid's a freshman. He is going to be something special. And here's Rowe, little fall-away jump shot. Knocks it down there. Javon Porter had 21 points, wins game MVP as Tolton wins it 74-65. Rockbridge taking on Pattonville. Fast start for the Bruins and Hudson Durstor. He gets a catch and shoot triple from the inbound. Knocks it down. Then a couple possessions later, it's the same shot from the other side of the court. Knocks it down here. Rockbridge led by as much as 11, but Pattonville rallied back. Kellen Thomas attacks the basket, finishes the and one layup. This one went back and forth into the fourth quarter. Now a tie game in the final minutes. It's Zion Hampton, the huge corner three-pointer to give Pattonville the lead for good. Hampton had 18 points and the Pirates win at 54-53. Bishop Miege of Kansas taking on the Helias Crusaders, the man himself. Helias' Desmond White drains the three-pointer. Helias leads 8-2 in the first quarter. And number two, once again, right after the previous play, putting on a show. Here's a slam dunk to make the lead 10-2. Now watch this play. The start of Bishop Miege's comeback. Kristen Bowen Webb comes in with a reverse layup. What a shot there. And Helias kept fighting through. Malcolm Davis takes the ball from Stag's hands. Ends out with an easy layup, but Bishop Miege wins it 69-64. We knew all year how great the Mexico Bulldog football program was, but what about Bulldogs basketball? They won their district a year ago and a chance to showcase last night in prime time. The 10 p.m. game last night, Mexico taking on St. Michael. Anthony Shivers takes it from the baseline, drives in for the bank shot. Bulldogs dominated from the jump later on the defensive end. It's Michael White. We caught a lot of his touchdowns this year in football. He gets the seal, a little coast-to-coast action, goes in for the easy right-handed layup. And now watch this, 3 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Isaiah Reams inbounds it to Shivers, gets a little bit of a running head start. Half court heave, money. Knocks it down, maybe the shot of the tournament. Mexico wins easily 68-42. The 4 a.m. game between Hickman boys and Raytown South. Isaiah Bonaparte with a long pass to Henry Wilson for Hickman's first points. What would be a pretty much neck and neck game for a long time. Corey Costner, who drives to the basket here, he had 19 points in the game, helped Hickman start to pull away. And this three-pointer also by Costner, he helped ignite a 21-7 run for Hickman to put it out of reach. Hickman gets a win over Raytown South 57-41. This game wrapped up just about an hour or so ago. Hickman girls taking on Vashon, and Saray Stemmons starts this one with a three-pointer for the QBs, and this one was never close. Ashlyn Klusmeyer had 18 points. She gets a contested shot in the paint here, and the breakaway layup here on the pass from Jayla Griffith to help Hickman take a 29-7 lead at the end of the first quarter, and the QBs wouldn't stop there. Ella Rogers was Hickman's top scorer with 19. She gets a triple there, and here's another her top of the key. This is one of her 4 three-pointers. She was the game's MVP. The QBs took over the win 64-31. The 3,577-day wait is nearly over. The last time Missouri played Kansas in regulation basketball, the Chiefs starting quarterback was Kyle Orton. The first Hunger Games movie was still about a month from release, and the top song on the charts was We Are Young. Most of us remember that game aren't so young anymore. The border war has not happened since an exhibition game in 2017 and haven't played a regular season game since 2012. This will be the first time Konzo Martin and his Tigers will step foot into Allen Fieldhouse, and he said in a press conference yesterday he appreciates how important this game is for fans and former players.
Yeah, it's just basketball, but it's also history. You're also talking about one of the best venues in the country, playing a college basketball game. So all of that matters. I mean, but again, once the ball is tipped, it's simply basketball at that point. But you have to enjoy everything that comes with it.
The Tigers will tip off against the Jayhawks at 2:15 today in Lawrence. I'll have coverage this afternoon from Lawrence, so make sure to stay active with @KOMU Sports on Twitter. And that's it for sports.